We all know that the plastic is useful for us. Yes, there are so many uses of plastic. Yes, it is used for making buckets, chairs, and other handle of utensils also. Now, next we will discuss is the special uses that are there. Okay, the first is that it is used in healthcare industry. Okay. For example, the syringes that are used in hospitals are made from plastics. Okay, the stitching wounds, the threads that are used for stitching wounds are also made up of plastic and packaging of tablets. Okay, in the healthcare industry, these are the things that in which the plastic is useful. Okay, at home we also use microwave. Yes, there are special type of microwave containers are there. Yes, that make our food warm, but nothing will happen to the plastic. Okay, and third is there is special type of plastic Teflon. Okay, that is used to prepare non-stick pans or fry pans. Okay, that means that food that oil or water does not stick to this type of plastic. It is covered on the utensils. Okay, on the cookware that we use. Okay, non-stick. Okay, that means oil and water does not stick to it. Yes, many types of pans are made from this type of plastic. Okay, next is we all know that plastic catch fire. Yes, but there is a special type of coating that is done to the clothes of firemen. Okay, that is of melamine. Okay, that is, it does not catch fire. Okay, now these are the uses of plastic. Next we will, there is a table 3.3 that is given on page number 38. There is a type of waste, yes, and approximate time taken to degenerate. Okay, and nature of material also. Yes, there are two types of material that we have discussed, biodegradable and non-biodegradable. Plastic bags come into the non-biodegradable waste and it takes several years to get degenerate. Yes, plastic does not degenerate easily. If we burn the plastic, then it produces so many types of gases. Yes, that are harmful for people that are suffering from any respiratory disease also. Okay, plastic is harmful for animals also. Yes, that plastic get enter into the stomach lining of the animals. Okay, that are also fatal for the animal. Yes, then next is on page number 39. There is a 4R principle. Yes, what is the meaning of 4R? We will discuss now. Okay, 4R principle means the first R is reduce, reuse, second is reuse, third is recycle, and fourth is recover. The first meaning of reduce, that we should reduce the use of plastic. Okay. For example, we should reduce the use of plastic. Yes, plastic bags that we use. Okay, decrease its amount by using it. Okay, so you can use other bags also. For example, jute bags and cotton bags. Okay, then next up is reuse. You should reuse again. You should reuse again and again. Okay. What is the meaning of reuse? That you can use it again and again. For example, plastic bags, we can use it again and again. Okay. Third is recycle. That we can send it to the. For example, हम किसी ना किसी को अपना जो वेस्ट है प्लास्टिक का वो किसी ना किसी को दे देते हैं ताकि वो आके रिसाइकल किया जा सके. ओके, सो रिसाइकल व्हाट इट मींस दैट वी शुड गिव वेस्ट थिंग्स फॉर रिसाइकलिंग. ओके, फॉर रिसाइकलिंग. देयर आर सो मेनी थिंग्स दैट आर मेड फ्रॉम रिसाइकलिंग. For example, we can recycle toys again and again. Polythene can also be recycled again and again. Now next step is recover. So what is the meaning of recover? When we have done all these processes, we as are done, we have reduced, reused and recycled the plastic. Now next step, if there is still waste left over, what we can do? We can use it for making energy, to get energy.
Himani ma'am, excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
Please make me host because students are waiting in the waiting room.
Okay, I'm just. Yes. Now, after the three processes are done. Okay, if we still left over with any waste, what we can do? We can recover the waste and can produce energy from it. Okay, or meaning of four are clear to all. Now next is okay. Coming on page number 40, there is an important point. It is fifth point, the different types of fibers different from one another in their strength, water absorbing capacity, nature of burning, cost, durability. For example, silk is different from polyester. Okay, they have different type of strength. Yes, they have a different they also differ in their absorbance power. Yes, so it is an important point that all fibers are not same. They are differ in many types of properties. The rest of the things we have discussed. Now coming to the back exercise, page number 41. Yes, the first question is, explain why some fibers are called synthetic. Yes, the first question is this: all fibers are not natural fibers. Yes, there are also some synthetic fibers also. Why they are synthetic? Because these are synthesized by men in industries or factories. Yes, and they use chemicals for making the fibers. Therefore, these are called synthetic fibers. Okay, because these are artificially made. Yes, first question is clear to all. Students, I will discuss these all question answers with you, and then I will send notes of these question answers. Okay, you have to frame answers in your own words. words. Yes, you understand my point? We will not give the hints of these answer also. We will send you notes. From that notes, you will find the answer by your own and make in your own words and frame answer in your own words. Okay. Second is MCQ. Mark the correct answer. Rayon is different from synthetic fibers because it has a silk-like appearance. B, it is obtained from wood pulp. C, its fiber can also be woven like those of natural fibers. Yes, who know the answer, please raise your hand. Yes, Nishka.
It is obtained from wood pulp.
Yes. B is correct answer. It is obtained from wood pulp. Now next is fill in the blanks with appropriate words. A synthetic fiber. Synthetic fibers are also called dash and dash fibers. What are the other names of synthetic fibers? Jay Gupta.
Artificial fibers.
Yes. Another name? There are two blanks.
Artificial.
Artificial or man-made fibers. Sorry, man-made fiber. There are two blanks. First you can write man-made. And in the second, you can write artificial. Okay. B part, synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw materials called dash. From where we synthesize synthetic fibers? Yes, Prabhnur.
Ma'am, synthetic fibers are synthesized from raw materials called petrochemicals.
Petrochemicals, yes. Petro, P-E-T-R-O-C-H-E-M-I-C-A-L-S. Petrochemicals. Okay, now next C part. Like synthetic fiber, plastic is also a dash. Plastic is also a dash. Yes, Sahajpreet.
Like synthetic fibers, plastic is also a polymer.
Yes, it is a polymer that it is made from from many units. Okay. Now next, give examples which indicate that nylon fibers are very strong. We have discussed this. We have discussed these examples that nylon is very strong fiber. Yes, what are the examples? Anyone please raise your hand. Jannat, yes, bachche, give the examples that show that the nylon fibers are strong. Mahib?
Ma'am, nylon fiber is very strong as it is used for making parachutes and ropes for rock climbing. It is also used for making fishing nets and seat belts and strings for sport rackets and musical instruments like violin.
Yes. Parachutes are made from nylon. Okay, as we know that they have to withstand with the air. Yes, so nylon is used in parachutes. Yes, and second, these are used for making ropes that are used in rock climbing. Okay. Next is explain why plastic containers are favored for storing food. Students, if we want to reduce the plastic, we can use steel tiffins or steel containers also for storing food. Yes, that will be more useful for our environment. Yes. So, The next question is, explain why plastic containers are favored for storing food. Yes, because these are non-corrosive. Yes, they do not react with air and water. And what are the other uses of plastic? That it is cheap, it has a high strength. Yes, anyone want to add point into this?
Ma'am, it is lightweighted.
It is lightweight, yes, and it is easy to handle also, and it is cheap.
Ma'am,
yes,
easy to handle.
Yes, it is also there is another point also, that is it is non-reactive. Yes, it does not react with the food that you will store in plastic. Okay, for example, pickles. It does not react with, it is non-reactive in nature. Okay, in the next question, explain the difference between thermoplastic and thermosetting plastics. This question we have discussed in the starting, when we have started the topic plastics. Yes, we have also done the difference of these two types of plastics. Yes, yes, Jannat, you know the answer. What is the difference between thermosetting and thermoplastic?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Give any one point.
Plastics which get deformed easily on heating and can be bent easily are called thermoplastics.
Yes.
The plastics which, when molded once, cannot be softened by heating, they are called thermosetting plastics.
Yes, good. Jashandeep Singh, you know any other difference, bachche? Don't worry, don't hesitate to answer. Yes, the second difference is that the thermoplastic cannot be used at high temperature. Okay, while the thermosetting plastics are used at high temperature. Yes. Now, the third difference is that the thermoplastic can be recycled. Okay, and while the thermosettings cannot be recycled. Can anyone give me example of thermoplastic?
Ma'am.
PVC.
Ma'am, PVC and polyethylene.
Yes,
PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride. Yes.
And polythene.
Spelling is P-O-L-Y, poly, vinyl, chloride. Yes? P-O-L-Y-V-I-N-Y-L-C-H-L-O-R-I-D-E, polyvinyl chloride. Yes? Example of thermosetting plastic.
Bakelite.
Yes. Now, coming to the next seventh question.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, इस क्वेश्चन में ये भी आ सकता है पॉइंट दैट थर्मोप्लास्टिक्स आर फॉर्म्ड बाय लीनियर अरेंजमेंट एंड थर्मोसेटिंग प्लास्टिक्स आर फॉर्म्ड बाय क्रॉस
लिंक्स. You can write this point also, that there is either linkage, either linear or cross link, but there are few cross links in thermoplastic. Okay, and in thermosetting there are numerous cross links that are there in thermosetting plastic. Okay, you can write also this point also. The next is, explain why the following are made of almost setting plastic. First is saucepan handles. Why they are made up of saucepan handles are made up of thermosetting plastic? Yes, Prabhu.
Handles of saucepan are made up of thermosetting plastic, as thermosetting plastic is a poor conductor of heat, and when the saucepan handle is heated, the thermosetting plastic does not allow heat to pass through, and the user can lift saucepan easily.
Yes, the first reason is that it is bad conductor of electricity and heat also. Yes, and the second is that on heating it do not deform. Yes, it doesn't change its shape. Therefore, the saucepan handles are made from thermosetting plastics. Okay. The B part is electric plug, switches, and plug boards are also made up of thermosetting plastic. Why? What is the reason? Jashandeep Singh? Yes, bachche?
Thermosetting plastics are a bad conductor of electricity.
Yes.
So they protect the person using the switches and plugs from getting shock.
Oh, yes, it is a bad conductor of heat and electricity both. Yes, it does not allow the current to pass through it, and does not, and the person will not feel any type of current or any shock. Yes. Now, next is categorize the materials of the following products into can be recycled and cannot be recycled. You have to just choose the material that can be recycled and cannot be recycled. Okay, the first is telephone instruments. It can be recycled or not?
I'm not.
No, it is not recycled. No. Cannot be recycled. Okay, and the next is plastic toys.
Yes,
it can be recycled.
Ma'am, telephone instruments kyun nahi recycle ho sakte?
Sorry,
ma'am, telephone instruments kyun nahi kiye ja sakte recycle?
Telephone instrument, because these can't be recycled, because uska jo material hai telephone ka, जो उनके जो पार्ट्स बनाए जाते हैं वो ऐसे रफ या प्लास्टिक से नहीं बनाए जाते हैं, दैट डज नॉट गेट हार्म. ओके, दैट डज नॉट गेट हार्म इजीली. ओके, इफ फॉर एग्जांपल टॉयज, यू कैन मोल्ड द टॉयज ऑफ फॉर एग्जांपल पॉलीथिन, इट चेंजेस इट्स शेप, बट टेलीफोन इंस्ट्रूमेंट जो है वो इतनी जल्दी अपनी जो शेप भी इतनी जल्दी चेंज नहीं करते हैं. ठीक है ना, दीज आर मेड अप फ्रॉम बेस्ट मटीरियल. ओके, नॉट फ्रॉम एनी मटीरियल दैट आर रिसाइकल्ड अगेन एंड अगेन. यस
मैम.
ओके,
यस मैम.
नेक्स्ट इज कुकर हैंडल्स. दीज आर ऑल्सो कैन नॉट बी रिसाइकल्ड. यस, बिकॉज द हैंडल्स आर मेड फ्रॉम the thermosetting plastics. Okay, that does not get deform easily. Carry bags.
Yes,
these can be recycled. Ballpoint pens.
No.
Obviously, these can be again.
No.
It can be recycled. Yes.
मैम, बॉल पॉइंट पेन्स रिसाइकल हो सकते हैं?
यस
मैम, बॉल पॉइंट पेन्स रिसाइकल हो सकते हैं?
द बॉडी ऑफ द प्लास्टिक पेन कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड.
ओके मैम.
यस. नेक्स्ट इज प्लास्टिक कवरिंग ऑन इलेक्ट्रिकल वायर्स. यस, इट कैन बी रिसाइकल्ड. प्लास्टिक चेयर्स.
यस.
Yes, it can also be recycled. Electrical switches that are made from Bakelite. Okay, these, it is an example of thermosetting plastic. Okay, so these cannot be recycled. Next is ninth question. Rana wants to buy shirts for summer. Should he buy cotton shirts or shirt made from synthetic material? Advise Rana, giving your reason. Okay. Which type of material should Rana buy? Cotton or any cotton shirt or synthetic material
cotton.
Shirt?
Cotton.
Cotton.
In the back
yes. Why?
Ma'am, because cotton, cotton can absorb more moisture.
Bad conductor.
Flow of air.
Yes, because cotton absorbs the sweat. Yes, and also that the pores that are present in the cotton fiber allows the sweat to evaporate. Yes, by which the person feel cool. Okay. So rather than synthetic fiber which do not absorb sweat, so Rana should buy cotton shirts for summer. Yes, because the absorbance of cotton and synthetic material is different. Okay, cotton is have the best absorbance power than the synthetic material. Now next is give examples to show that plastic are non-corrosive in nature. That it does not corrode easily.
Ma'am.
For example, yes.
Ma'am, answer ke liye kaha tha.
Okay. Other students.
And.
What are the examples that, for example, plastic chair does not get corroded easily, but rather than iron articles? Okay. The next is yes, your voice is not clear.
Ma'am, they do not get rusted.
Yes, obviously, they do not get rusted. Also, we use plastic for storing many types of materials. Food items, we can store many types of food items also. Okay?
And they do not decompose easily.
Your voice is not clear, bachche.
Ma'am, they do not decompose easily.
The point is of non-corrosive. Okay?
Ma'am, it does not show any chemical change. Ma'am, hota hi nahi hai ma'am usme.
What you are saying?
Ma'am, it do not show any chemical change.
It does not show any
chemical change.
Yes, it does not show any chemical change. Okay, the plastic does not get rusted also. And the second point is that we can store food items in plastic also. Yes, that it will not react when we store a food items in plastic. It does not react with air and water as the iron do. Okay, iron get rusted only in the presence of air and water. Yes, but plastic does not get rusted in the presence of air and water. Yes, the next is, should the handles and bristles of a toothbrush be made of the same material? Explain your answer. Yes, other students? Devani?
Ma'am, may I tell the answer?
Ma'am, may I?
Bhavya? Other students don't know the answer of this question? Yes, Jay Gupta?
Ma'am, no handles and bristles of toothbrush should not be made from same material. Handle of toothbrushes should be heat from plastics because plastics are very strong and durable. They are light in weight and they are non-corrosive. Bristles should be made from nylon because
bristles of plastic
because
are also,
they are thin fibers.
Listen to me. The bristles of toothbrush are also made up of plastic, but there is a difference that the handles should be strong. Okay, because we have to hold the handle, it should be strong. It should not be weak that when we hold it get molded. Yes, but the bristles should be soft and flexible also. Okay, if the bristles are strong, then it will harm to our teeth. Yes, so what is the conclusion of this question is that the handle of the toothbrush needs to be strong. Yes, and less flexible, while the bristles of toothbrush should be soft and highly flexible. Okay, these are not made up of same material. Okay, these are made up from different materials. Yes, the next is